evening of late, as I happened to stray to the county Tipperary, I straight took me way to dig the potatoes and work by the day for a farmer called Darby O'Leary. I asked him how far we were bound for to go, the night being dark and a cold wind did blow. I was hungry and tired and me spirits were low, for I got neither whiskey nor water. The dirty old miser, he mounted his steed to the Galbally Mountains, he rode in great speed. I followed behind till me poor feet did bleed when we stopped, when his old horse was weary. When we came to his cottage, I entered it first. It seemed like a kennel, a ruined old church. Says I to myself, I am left in the lurch in the house of old Darby O'Leary. I well recollect it was Michaelmas night, to a hearty good supper he did me invite. A cup of sour milk that was more green than white, and it gave me the trotting disorder. The wet old potatoes would poison the cats, and the barn where me bed was swarming with rats. The fleas would have frightened the fearless St. Pat, who banished the snakes o'er the border. We worked me by day, and he worked me by night, while he held an old candle to give me some light. I wish these potatoes would die of the blight, or himself would go off with the fairies. 'Twas on this old miser I looked with a frown, when the straw was brought in for to make me shake down. And I wish that I'd never seen him, nor his town, nor the sky over Derby O'Leary. I've worked in Kilconnell, I've worked in Kilmore, I've worked in Knockanny and Shanballamore, and Pallas and Nicker and Salahadmore, with farmers so decent and cheery. I've worked in Tipperary, the Rag and Ross Green, at the Mount of Kilfaithkill, the Bridge of Aileen. Such woeful starvation I never yet seen, as I got from old Darby O'Leary.